Peter Betty.
Oh my God, that fly!
Ignite Denver, what's up? How we doing? So I'm here to talk to you guys about my nightmare of student loans and just completely max out credit cards and lots of them. But before we go into that, I'm going to give you guys a little bit of contextual information. First of all, I was lucky. I went to undergrad at DU and graduated without any significant loans. I studied psychology. Got an interest in entrepreneurship and figured, why not go get a master's degree in business, right? Ended up with $100,000 student loans. And the message I'm here to tell you guys is that money might not be the thing stopping you from launching your startup. And it might. If it is, I'm here to convince you it's not. Part of entrepreneurship. Anyway, when I was going to school, I figured I better launch a business before graduating, otherwise I'm just going to be stuck interviewing, which is the same boat I was in when graduating undergrad. Launched a business halfway through. It was a real estate company. It was slow. I wasn't really able to pay myself anything at all. And it was called Holmes Real Estate Group because I didn't know how to name businesses back then. We basically took out-of-state investment and purchased single-family homes here in Denver, which we know the real estate's gone up, and we rented to people, young folks just like you and I that are moving here. And that's the real estate company. I spent 24 months paying myself $300 a month. And can anyone live off $300 a month? No, neither could I. But one thing I was good at was getting credit cards and getting high limits and maxing those out. And what I realized is the houses were appreciated. It was great news. The houses were worth more. And my credit card debt was also quickly rising every year. I'd have quite a bit more, but I couldn't really access what was in the houses. And it wasn't always that much. So I started worrying about this credit card debt, and I started thinking, well, what's the worst that could happen? I'm probably not going to end up in the cemetery, hospital, or jail, right? Three bad things. So, but there are some consequences, so let's talk about them. I mean, bad credit score, right? We're all scared about that. Phone calls, you owe us money, Matt. Bam. Embarrassment, taking a date out to dinner, your card getting declined. Classic. And of course, we all know there's a lot of high interest that you pay in the long run. So here's me kind of trying to balance student loans, which, by the way, were increasing because the interest, and that's a large amount. And here's credit cards each year, $2,000, $25,000, a little bit more. So you guys want to know the maximum amount? The best? Let me pause for a second. Creditkarma.com at the bottom here is a great resource I use to educate on credit and learn how I could eventually get $85,000 of credit card debt. But finally, things changed. After those 2 years of not making any money on the real estate company, I ended up selling a condo that the real estate company owned and was able to pay off investors and actually have some cash to pay off the debt. So I realized, wow, that was a crazy run. Entrepreneurship's insane. You can use credit to do that. But I didn't have a purpose. I wanted to find something a little bit more meaningful. So I focused on these things. I wanted to help other entrepreneurs. I wanted to write a book. I wanted to find purpose. And so that's why I launched this next company. By the way, that's my most recent book. If you guys want to check it out, Handshaking Your Way to Entrepreneurial Success, because the Handshaking video series is the new company I launched, where I get to go and interview top entrepreneurs on how networking and psychology works, bringing it back to my undergraduate degree. It was sweet. We've interviewed venture capitalists, a billionaire, a member of Congress. Like, there's some insane stuff that works for networking and you're an inspiring entrepreneur. And so final thoughts. An MBA can teach you how to balance debt, right? Like, the curriculum is great, but you get to learn how to deal with $100,000 in student loans. And you don't have to risk the big things in life to launch your startup. You don't have to risk the cemetery, hospital, etc. And one other point that I didn't get to fast enough. Anyway, would I max out again? Absolutely. A true shot at entrepreneurship is a big deal for you guys. And sometimes you just have to go for it. Don't risk the big things because you don't have to. And stop stopping yourself. Maybe it's money, maybe it's something else. Do something big today. I want you guys to go out there after this event and do something. And I think a lot of you guys have a beard, man, and now I have a microphone apparently. But let's raise a hand for me. I need each of you in the audience. Raise a hand if you're going to do something today to reach your goals. Come on, everyone. Yes. You guys are awesome. Yeah. Nothing will stop you from your dreams. Just do it. Just do it. Anyway, tweet me your startup bite in at Hand Chicken. I want to tell you if I like your name or not, and I want to support you. Launch your companies if you're thinking about it, and do something today. Thank you, guys.
Dude's gonna have a heart attack in like 5 minutes.